Hi, welcome to another session of Quant. Try to solve the questions on your own before you look at the solutions. That should help you better in terms of your learning. There will be some questions which are tough, some questions which are easy. So see, you can identify the easy and tough sums before you start solving it. Let's start. A and B are two points in a river with the water flowing from A to B. Speed of P is twice that of Q. P starts from A. So P starts from A and Q starts from B. And they move towards each other. So speed of P is 2x and speed of Q is x. Time taken for them to meet is 30 minutes. So time is equal to 30 minutes. Now we don't know the speed of water flowing from A to B. Let the speed of water flowing be s. That means the speed of p will be 2x plus s and speed of q will be x minus s. Okay, you can write it as 2x plus s and x minus s. So relative speed of 2 will be 2x plus s plus x minus s, because they're going in opposite direction. The relative speed is addition of the speeds, speed of p plus speed of q, which becomes 3x. Now they have said that P starts from B. So if P starts from B in the second case and Q starts from A from the third second case. Okay. So the speed of P is 2x, speed of Q is x. The actual speed of Q will be x plus s. The actual speed of P will be 2x minus s. So again, the relative speed is speed of P plus speed of Q, which is 2x minus s plus x plus s, which again ss gets cancelled, you will get 3x. So the speed before also was 3x, after also was 3x, the relative speed. So time taken should remain the same because distance is the same. So time taken should remain the same. So the answer should be 30 minutes. That should be the answer. Because its relative speed is same. If even if you p starts from A or p starts from B and vice versa, the relative speed of both will be 3x. And distance is the same, so time will be the same, which will be 30 minutes. A lot of sums on time for distance can be understood better if you just draw it. It becomes easier to solve. Three pipes PQR can fill the tank in 24 hours. Now they work for 8 hours. If they already work for 8 hours, that means 8 upon 24, one third of the tank is filled. Okay, one third of a tank is filled. So what is left is 2/3 of the tank. 2/3 of the tank is filled by P and Q in 20 hours. So P and Q fills 2/3 of the tank in 20 hours. So to fill complete tank, full tank, how long will it take? If you cross multiply 20 into 1 upon 2 upon 3, you should get 30 hours. Which means we know that P plus Q takes 30 hours. And all three, P plus Q plus R, takes 24 hours. Now we want R, how long does it take to fill? You can do by different methods, the LCM method, the normal method. Let's say LCM method, P plus Q, R, and we have P plus Q plus R is the sum of these. So P plus Q is 30 hours. P plus Q plus R is 24 hours. If you look at the LCM of the two, will be 120. If it's 120, 34 is 120. We assume 120 units of work. So P plus Q do 4 units of work. All three put together do 5 units of work. 24, 5 is 120. Which means R does only 1 unit of work. So since it does 1 unit of work, it will take 120 upon 1, 120 minutes to do the work. 1 unit of work. So to complete 120 units of work, it will take 120 hours, which is C option. So you can do by LCM method also, right? So first, when all three of them work, 1/3 is filled. Then P and Q fill the remaining 2/3 in 20 hours. So complete tank in how many hours? 30 hours. So P plus Q can fill complete tank in 30 hours. All three can fill in 24 hours. Then you can use the LCM method or any other method you're comfortable with. You will get the answer as 120. You can also do 1 upon 30 plus 1 upon X equal to 1 upon 24. Where 30 is for P and Q this is for R and this is for P plus Q plus R. Even this will get the answer. Three butterflies PQR fly from a point in three different directions at a constant speed of 2 meters per second. After a point, it is noticed that P is as much away from point A, which is the midpoint of Q and R. So let's draw Q and R. Midpoint is A. So P is as much away from A. Let's say P. So all these three has to be equal. Right? That's what I said. So P is as much away from point A, which is the midpoint of Q and R, as point Q is from A. It is known that the distance between Q and R is 100. So that means this will be 50 and 50 each. And this means P and Q is 60. So this is 60. At that point of time, R stops and calls both P and Q, who turns towards R at the original speed. So we have this diagram. Now, since these three lengths are equal, I normally look at a diameter and a radius. And a diameter subtends a right angle at any point on the circle. So if these three are length are equal, that means this has to be a right angle. Assuming QR is a diameter, P will lie on the circle because A becomes the center and AQ becomes the radius. That's how I imagine the thing. Which also means that QPR will be a right angle. QPR will be right angle. So if QPR is right angle, if QR is 100, PQ is 60, by Pythagoras triplet, you will get PR equal to 80. Remember Pythagoras triplet is 3, 4, 5. 3 stands for 60. 5 stands for 100. So 4 will stand for 80. So we get this diagram. Now both P and Q will reach R. So P takes how much time? P will take time 80 upon 2 meters per second, which is 40 seconds. Okay, distance upon speed. And Q will take again distance upon speed, which is 100 upon 2, 50 seconds. So we can make out that P will reach quicker and he will reach by 10 seconds quicker than Q. This is C option. P will reach quicker than Q and by 10 seconds. So we get the answer as C option. A retailer increases the price of laptop by exactly the same amount as cost price went up. One way to solve maybe is just assume numbers and try to figure out. Okay, let's say initially the cost price is 100 and let's say selling price becomes 120. I'm just randomly putting numbers. So profit becomes 20 and the profit percent becomes 20%. Let me say that the cost price is increased by let's say 20. So selling price also will increase by 20. That's what they said. Prices of laptop is increased by same as cost price, so 140 it will go for. So profit will remain 20. So 20 out of 120 is 1 upon 6, and you should know 1 upon 6 is 16.66%. So we know 16.66%. So we know that profit after is less than profit before. Since profit after is less than profit before, we can definitely make out that C option is not possible, and even A option is not possible. So we're left with B and D option, where profit after has to be less than profit before. Now let's look at this scenario. The moment they put mod sign and they said loss, that means loss also is possible. Let's look at a concept of loss. 100, say selling price is 80, loss is 20, 20% is loss, profit percent is 20, so minus 20 and minus 20%. I reduce by 20, say 80, 60 reduced by 20. So loss is 20 upon 80, which is minus 20 is a loss, which is minus 25%. Okay, one error that I've done out here is an increase in the price. So my mistake, this should be 120 and this should be 100. So the loss will remain 20. The loss will become minus 16.66%. This is profit after. So if this is profit after, again, if you look at it, profit after is bigger than profit before in this case. If profit after is bigger than profit before, you can make out that even D option ruled out. But since it's negative, you can make out that mod of profit before Okay, if I put and mod of profit after, they're negative, right? Mod of profit before will be bigger than mod of profit after. So automatically we can make out B will be the answer. Also, this is equal to sign. The equal to sign is because when the profit is zero, then there'll be equal to sign. So if there's no profit, no loss, then the before and after profit will remain zero and zero, which will be equal. So answer is B. So you can just assume numbers and try to solve. That is one good way of trying to solve. Even as you can make it out by just looking at the numbers that as and when the selling price will, cost price will increase, the profit percent can go down and the loss percent can go up, you can directly mark the answer as B. Else, putting numbers and trying to solve also is a good way of solving. Rectangular sheet of 40 by 30. If I look at 40 by 30 is a rectangular sheet, 10 centimeters cut everywhere. If 10 centimeters cut, then this will become 20 because 10 and 10 is cut. So this becomes 20 and this becomes 10 because again 10 and 10 is cut. So base of the box becomes 20 and 10. The base of the box becomes 20 and 10 and the height becomes 10. So volume will become 20, 10, length, breadth and height and 10, which will become 2000 square meters. So automatically you get 2000 square meters as the volume, that will give you the answer, right? Just draw, understand the figure and you should be able to get the answer to this, right? I hope this helps. Thank you.